Anne from Game Like a Mother. Today I'm going to show you how to play Rat-a-Tat Roll by Game Right. It's for ages 6 and up, 2 to 5 players, and it takes about 15 minutes to play a game. Let me show you how it works. Here is a game set up for 3 players. Each player starts out with 1 card that they get to look at, and then they have to face back down and they don't get to look at again unless they have a special ability to do so, and they start with 2 reroll hot air balloon tokens. The Catchew of Liberty is what you take turns moving around the board, and it starts on one of the black wild spots, and you put 1 card face up in front of each of the color sections. Your goal of the game is to acquire 4 cards that add up to the lowest total. When it is your turn, you can choose to roll 1 to 3 of these dice, and you add up the total, and then you land on one of these spots. The card spot, you get to either pick up this card or draw a card from the center, which you get to look at and then place with your hand. The hot air balloon card, you pick up this card and you get to have a reroll token added to your hand. The cheetah spot, you pick up this card and you get to choose to either look at your entire hand at this point, so however many cards you have, you get to look at the whole hand, or you can choose to look at one of your opponent's cards, just one, not their whole hand. And if you land on the wild card spot, you get to roll the dice, and if you roll the rat, you have to pick up the highest card that is out on the board. If you roll the cat, you get to pick up the lowest card on the board. 0's lowest, 9's highest in this game. And if you roll this, it means you get to swap with someone. So without looking, you could swap with an opponent. And that is your turn. Let me explain how hot air balloons work. So if you land on a hot air balloon spot, you get a hot air balloon. Also, if you land on a spot where you get a card with a hot air balloon on it, you get a hot air balloon for that. And then if you land also on the hot air balloon spot, you get an additional one. So if you land on any of these spots and you're getting this card, you get a hot air balloon. But if you land on the special hot air balloon spot, you get 2. Also, if at any point there are 3 hot air balloon cards around the board, you pick up the cards around the board, shuffle them back into the deck, and re-deal out the face-up cards around the board. To play the hot air balloons, you have to have rolled the dice and not moved yet. You can count out your spots and see where you have landed. And if you choose, you can play a hot air balloon and re-roll as many of the dice that you originally rolled. And you can also use it on the wild die, which is what we end up using it on most when we play. Okay, let's skip ahead and see what the end of a game looks like. In a 3 to 5 player game, the game ends when each player has 4 cards. In a 2-player game, it would end when you get 5 cards each. So here, let's say it's my turn. I have 4 cards. This opponent still has only 3. So I no longer get to move the Catchew of Liberty. I get to choose whether or not I wish to roll the wild die. Let's say, nah, I don't feel like it. I like my cards. Goes on to this player's turn. They roll the dice and then they move the Catchew of Liberty to whatever they roll. They go ahead and pick up this card, replace it with a new one, and now they have started the final round of play where each player has a turn to decide whether or not they wish to roll the wild die. So if this person goes, yes, they wish to roll it, they roll the rat, use a reroll, roll the rat again, use a reroll, oh no, they got the rat, so they have to pick between the 2 highest cards, place it in their hand, and then this card goes to the bottom of the draw pile, and a new card is put out. It's my turn. Okay, I want to roll. So I roll a kitty and I get to take the lowest card that is out, put it in my hand, and this goes into the bottom of the draw pile. A new card is placed out. This person chooses to roll and they get a switch. Hooray! They switch with me and the game is over. So all we need to do is flip over cards, see who has the lowest score. This person does this time. In the case of a tie, what we usually do is whoever has the most rerolls left is the winner, or whoever has the lowest card in their hand wins. So that's how to play Rat-a-Tat Roll. If a kid likes Rat-a-Tat Cat and is ready for a little more strategy, it's a great pick. Thanks, and see you next time from Game Like a Mother.